Welcome to Jackson Memorial High School, to our incoming freshmen and new students. We look forward to having you this year. Certainly the start of the school year may look a little different to all of us, but in essence, we are looking forward to having an outstanding year. Lots of clubs, sports and activities, an enriched curriculum. And in our presentation today, you're gonna see several of our students and staff members. They're gonna take you around our school, and we look forward to working with you. Each year, our seniors produce a very special video, and it shows you lots of the clubs, sports, and activities that you all hopefully experience.
Hold on to me as we go, as we roll down this unfamiliar road. And although this wave is stringing us along, just know you're not alone, 'cause I'm gonna make this place your home. Settle down, it'll all be clear. Don't pay no mind to the demons, they fill you with fear. The trouble in my drag.
Welcome class of 2024 for our first ever virtual student orientation. I hope you and your families are safe as we are all adjusting to the pandemic of COVID-19. As the assistant principal overseeing our new student orientation, we share in your disappointment that we cannot be together on the 26th. So we are looking forward to getting things back to normal whenever that is, which means participating in sports, clubs, activities, and all they have to offer. We'll make sure that you have a list of our clubs, sports, and activities so that you can get immersed in Jackson Memorial High School. During our previous new student orientations, I always bring up my personal connection with you, the incoming students. Because like many of you, I was a Switlick student, I was a Get student, and I was a Jackson Memorial student. I think that's a pretty cool connection to have. A lot is going on right now in the world and in our building, and we're trying to navigate through these uncharted waters. Our building is making sure we are prepared for any scenario as we get closer to the beginning of the school year. On behalf of our guidance department, our staff, our administrative team, Mr. DeGenia, our building principal, Mr. McDevitt, our assistant principal, Ms. Novak, our assistant principal, we welcome you virtually to Jackson Memorial High School and look forward to interacting with you when it is safe to do so. Thank you again and see you soon.
Hey guys, I'm Mr. Panicue. I'm the athletic director here at Jackson Memorial High School, as well as Jackson Liberty High School. First and foremost, I'd like to welcome you aboard and looking forward to working with all of you in some endeavor. Just to talk real briefly about athletics, you know, we offer over 28 sports at all levels, and we really feel very strongly here in the district, and I could tell you from personal experience that we feel very strongly that being involved in extracurricular and athletics really helps make you a much more well-rounded student and really prepares you for the next level, whether it be college or the workplace. So we really think that there's attributes there from work ethic, from teamwork, from friendships, from, you know, just organization, and that really help you in your academic adventures. So a couple things, you know, obviously this year is a little bit different. We're dealing with some different in different time right now, and we're battling through just knowing all the different guidelines and protocols that are put in place. So I can assure you that we're going to do everything we can within those guidelines and those protocols to give you every opportunity to participate on the athletic field. So please be patient, be understanding that things are a little different. Practices may look a little different than they have in the past, may have some different protocols, but we are going to do whatever we can under those guidelines to help you and hope that you have a season. You know, I talked a little bit about academics, but you know, you start off fresh as a freshman, so you're clean slate. But during your freshman year, it's important that you pass your classes, at least 15 credits per semester, for you to be eligible again for continuing seasons, maybe next year or the future. You know, we want you to make sure that, you know, we have a great tradition here. We do some great things athletically, but we have very high expectations of our student athletes, behaviorally in particular. And obviously, you know, what I want you to do is make sure that you abide by all the rules that are given to you throughout the school. And then lastly, you know, we really have take great pride in what we do. We know it's hard work. We know that it's a big commitment from you, but we think it's definitely rewarding. So please do everything you can to stay in shape, do what you can as a person to be prepared for the season, and we're here to give you anything else that you need. So if you have any questions or concerns throughout the school year, you can always stop down or reach out to me, Mr. Panicue, and I'll be glad to help you. So again, welcome aboard, and we wish you the best of luck.
Hi, good morning. My name is Meritas Dolphin. I'm one of the two nurses here at Jackson Memorial High School.
That's our contact information on screen. There's a certified school nurse assigned to every health office during regular school hours. Students should report to the health office for any medical problem or when prescribed medication must be dispensed. Medication, both prescribed and over-the-counter, requires a doctor's written order and a parental permission in order to be dispensed in school. Should your student require the use of crutches due to an injury or illness, a physician's order must be provided to the school nurse. The school nurse cannot diagnose or treat injuries that occur outside of school. Referrals will be made if the school nurse determines this action appropriate. Parents should notify the school nurse if their child has been diagnosed with any chronic health problem, life-threatening allergic condition, and if diagnosed with communicable disease. Contact the school nurse for specific permission forms and to advise the school nurse if your student is receiving any medication at home. Students should remain at home if they appear ill, and parents or guardians should notify the health office about specific medical problems. All contagious illnesses are to be reported to the school nurse immediately. A physician's clearance is necessary prior to the child returning to school. We consider fever to be present in a child whose temperature is above 100.4 degrees orally. All febrile children should be kept home from school until the child is fever-free for 24 hours without the use of fever-reducing medication. Parents or guardians need to have an alternate plan in place should their student become ill during school day. If they are a distance from the school, another emergency contact should be obtained. Students will be excluded from school with temperature of over 100.4. If there are no other symptoms, the student may return after remaining fever-free for 24 hours without the use of fever-reducing medications. If fever is present with any of the following symptoms on screen, the student will be excluded until the following criteria are met. Fever-free for 72 hours without the use of fever-reducing medicine. Noticeable improvement of symptoms. 7 days have passed since start of symptoms. Or medical note of clearance. It is the goal to have the student isolated and removed from school as soon as possible. If the student is actively coughing, they will be asked to wear a mask until they are taken home. Please go to our district website, jacksonsd.org, for any of the following information and to download common medical forms.
If you have any further questions, feel free to contact me at extension 4644 or email me at mdolphin@jacksonsd.org. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Ms. Kearney, and I'm the Student Assistance Coordinator at Jackson Memorial High School. The SAC is part of a network of services available to students. In my position, I provide school assessment, intervention, counseling, and referral services to students who may be experiencing personal, family, or peer difficulties. The goal is to support students and prevent personal difficulties from interfering with their success in school. Students can be referred to the Student Assistance Program from anyone in the school community, including parents. Sometimes students even just stop and knock on my door and self-refer. The most common referral is when students come to me who are concerned about a peer. Because I exclusively help with personal issues, students who share information with me are protected under very strict confidentiality laws. For those students who need a higher level of support, I serve as a link to community-based agencies and resources. Finally, my office is located on the Clayton side of the building near Clayton office. And I am available to all students, so that if you need help, please reach out to me. I have a webpage that contains additional information about the Student Assistance Program, as well as contact information. The webpage can be accessed through the Jackson Memorial Guidance webpage. Good luck to the class of 2024, and welcome aboard.
Hi everyone, I'm Shayla Nagel, the class of 2021 president, and I just wanted to all let you know that this school has a great atmosphere all the time, no matter when you're walking through the halls. And this year might be a little bit different, but as long as you're patient and you have just an open mindset, you'll still have a great experience here. I remember 3 years ago when I was a freshman sitting in the same exact seat as you guys will be eventually. I was nervous coming into the school with kids that are older than you. There's just so many things offered here at the school, from so many different clubs to sports. It's definitely important to get yourself involved. But moreover, in the classroom, it's different than middle school. In high school, you have your GPA, your class rank. Everything is weighted a lot more different. You don't want to wait until your junior or senior year to start picking things up to get here for college. You want to start right from day one, make a great impression on your teachers, your grades, to time management is also extremely important. If you have work starts getting involved as you grow up, you have jobs, you have your sports and clubs, you need to make sure that you have time to get those homework assignments in, keep up your studying and everything. It really makes a big difference. And lastly, I just want to give you guys one last piece of advice. Just going into the school year this September, just keep a really open mindset. Things will happen, just be patient. Eventually you'll have just as good of a school year as everyone else will be. Memorial is here to help you guys. We want to give you as fun of a year in your next 4 years at Jackson Memorial. And always remember, once a Jag, always a Jag.
Hi, I'm Tiffany Duffy. I'm going to be a senior at Jackson Memorial High School. So here at Jackson Memorial, we have a lot of different classes that you could take, all from college prep, honors, AP. So we have a lot of different teachers that could help you with whatever level class that you're on. We also have a wide variety of electives, so everybody will be able to find what's they want to take and what interests them. Also, as former student council vice president, we work a lot with the Board of Education, so us as students have a voice and they get to hear our concerns and what's going on in our school. Also, being a part of student council, you get to work with planning homecomings, playing proms. We work with all of the classes, so you're assisting every single class. Student council is just one thing that you could sign up for of Jackson Memorial. We have a wide variety of clubs and activities, so you'll definitely find something that will interest you.
I'm Emily Antonucci, and I'm going to be a senior here at Jackson Memorial High School. I'm going to tell you about the main parts of the school. So first off here, right through these doors is the Memorial Office, where you'll find Miss Novak and Mr. Tarver. Miss Novak is last names A to G, and Mr. Tarver is H to O. There are two nurses in the school if you ever need. There's one in the memorial side, right through these doors, right by the office that I just talked about. And there's one also in Clayton, right by the cafeteria. If you ever need to know any information about sports, you can go down in the A wing, Ryder Hall, and there will be the athletic office. There are two gyms in this school. Freshmen and sophomores will be in the Clayton gym, but all main sporting events are in the Memorial gym. Also on the Memorial side is the weight room and wood shop. There are two cafeterias in the school as well. There's one on the Clayton side and Memorial side. It depends on your schedule, so you'll have to check in with your third period teacher to see which cafeteria you'll be in. If you're ever looking for the IMC or library, it's in the main hall in Memorial. I know Jackson Memorial may seem overwhelming, but one tip to know is if you're looking at your schedule, the 100s and 200s is on Memorial, and it's on the right side when you're facing the building. The 200s are upstairs and the 100s are downstairs. If your schedule has 400s, then that's Fine Arts and that's in the middle of the building. If your schedule has a 500 or 600, then your classes will be on the left side of the building in Clayton. Now I'm standing in the Fine Arts part of Jackson Memorial. It's the middle of the building, and if you walk through those doors, you'll see the Fine Arts office where you can find Mr. DiGino's office, and you can contact home there if you need it. Also in Fine Arts, you will find the auditorium where there's theater, and in the rear of Fine Arts, there's chorus and band rooms. Also in Fine Arts, they have the Jaguar where they sell apparel and food. Now I'm on the left side of the building, the Clayton side, and when you walk in, you'll see the Clayton office where you'll find Mr. McDevitt, who is P to Z, last names, and the guidance office. On this side of the building, you'll find the TV studio, the Clayton cafeteria, the Clayton gym, the Clayton nurse, and the lecture hall. I know it may seem like a lot, but all the teachers are willing to help if you ever get lost. Have a great school year. Good luck.
At Jackson Memorial High School, all freshmen and students have their own guidance counselor. And usually in the first year, classes like English 1, Algebra 1, even a few students that have STEM classes will be taken care of through the guidance office. So please reach out to your guidance counselor should you have any questions. You certainly can email them. Most of our guidance counselors will be in a few days before school starts. So if you have any questions or concerns, you can reach out to them at that point. Everybody have a great first year.